Welcome to Subramani. One peeve I've always had about investing is there are not enough women who are investing, or not enough women who are looking after the family money. If women can look after the health of the family, the education of the family, the growth of the family, the upbringing of the children, the running of the kitchen, right? These are the most vital things. And the most important thing for funding all this is money. I don't see why women do not play a role. So I just asked a few women, and the first reaction was, "Are you, investing is the only thing he does sitting at home other than watching TV and going for his tours, etc. So let him do that. I don't want to take that also. Then that will also come on to me, and then he will say, 'Ye redeem karo, ye invest karo, mujhe nahi karna hai.' I don't want to get into that. That is his job. Let him do it." So I said, who makes the bill payments, etc., for the electricity, gas, and telephone, and all that? So she said, oh, that also I do. Which means they know, they are equipped with technology. This couple is equipped with technology. She is able to do all this online. Yes, she uses his credit card to make some payments. In some cases, she has set up a mandate. In some cases, she has set up a mandate with a low figure, so that whenever the figure exceeds that, she has to intervene and make the payment. So she is using technology. It's not as though she's not using technology, but she's not come into investing. And she has no clue what her husband is doing. So I recently did an exercise for a few friends, and I asked the women why they were not investing. Again, they said, well, I've never been asked to invest. So that is one more problem, that the men don't communicate well. Men don't ask the women to do some of these things. So I think some of the division of labor which can happen is the investment should always be done jointly. If you want to invest, if the man wants to invest, he should ask the woman. If the woman wants to invest, she should ask the man. And they should both justify to each other why they are making that investment, whether it is a single share or whether it is a fund or whether it is buying some insurance policy or real estate. Real estate, I think women are a little more involved because they'll go and have a look and all that. But in financial investments, I don't think women get too involved for various reasons. One is one more reason which was given to me is my husband just doesn't trust me with the money. He thinks I will lose it and things like that. And I am also meeting women who earn a little more than their husbands, maybe marginally more. Maybe the husband has a take-home salary of 2 lakhs and the wife has a salary take-home of 2 lakh 10, which could be just, idhar udhar ki baat. So next year, this guy could be bringing home 2 lakh 32 and she could be bringing 2 lakh 25. It's perfectly possible that these things happen. But these women also, who are equal to their husbands, let's say both of them are earning 35,000 or both of them are earning 2,35,000, doesn't really matter much, right? Both are earning equally. With age, both their salaries have gone up. So this couple is around 43, 44 years of age, and they both bring home about slightly about 2 lakhs. But there is absolutely no involvement from her, and it's not that she's earning badly. But one more thing I realize is women who are earning very well, say with a salary of say 50, 60 lakhs, maybe they're 40 years of age, then they are more confident about investing, and then they look at and say, I can do a 3 lakh rupee SIP and this is what I think I should be doing. What do you think? And I know girls, women who run their direct equity portfolio, who buy some, fixed number of shares every month and that kind of a thing. I see all that happening. I wish it was more. I wish I had more viewers. I wish more women watched my videos. And I would love your comments down below as to why you are not in the market. Why are you not investing? Why are you not at least taking part in an index fund or in the mutual fund, which does not require too much participation from you, right? So what I suggested to a young couple who are about 30 years of age or 35 years of age is to create their own portfolios, which is imaginary portfolio. I said, you and your husband both create an imaginary portfolio in, say, a value research or a money control or somewhere. I will have the login and password, and you will not have each other's login and password. So the husband is not knowing what the wife is doing. Wife does not know what the husband is doing. Both started off with a 10 lakh rupee capital at the beginning of this year. So we are in June, so halfway, midway review is she is doing better than him, but marginally. Just like their salaries, they are doing marginally, but she's doing better. And that gives her confidence that she can do it herself. She does not need even a fund manager. No, she's not. She's underperforming fund manager. She's underperforming the index. But her choices have been very different from her husband. And I said, it will make a lot of sense for the two of you to sit and talk about your fund choices also, because she is applying her mind just as well here as he is applying. So if she can look after the family, there is no reason why she can't look after the money. And I do think that when your child is about 13, 14, 12 to 14 years of age, involve them in making all the payments, right? So your electricity payment and your all your utilities. Get your kids to be involved. Get your, of course, it's your money, it's your credit card which they are going to use. But instead of giving a standing instruction, or even to while giving the standing instruction, involve them saying how the standing instruction has to be created, how the OTP has to be used. I keep saying this, forget what others say about personal financial planning. There is nothing personal, there is nothing about finance. It is more about family communicating about money. So the husband is making an investment, the wife knows why he is making the investment. The children know how, from where the money is coming for paying the electricity bill and the other utilities, from where the school fees is paid. And why a younger kid who could be maybe 8 years of age, you give the cash to that kid and let that kid pay the salary to the domestic help, to the driver, whomever you're paying cash. I would encourage you to pay cash in smaller shops and other places, even in the mall, so that children see that something is going out for getting something back in value. So don't ask me why women are not investing. I ask me why the whole family is not involved in financial decision making. If four of you can go to buy a fridge which costs maybe 50,000 rupees, isn't it important that you, for all of you, be involved? Yes, if kids are below 13 years, they need not be explained as to why you are doing this. But you say, this money which I am putting in this fund, name the fund, absolutely no problem. Say, this is Shreya's education fund. This is Savita education fund. This is Dad's retirement fund. This is Mom's retirement fund. You can give them those names, and each fund is actually a scheme of 3-4 things. Like, I don't think recommend to anybody just put money in one pension plan and that is taken care of for life. No, the process is to create a retirement plan which could have one large cap, one mid cap, one multi cap, flexi cap fund, one large and mid cap, one flexi cap, one small cap, and a retirement plan, right? I would want this combination. Now, of course, retirement plans with full equity is available, so you don't need to do this. But even then, I might decide to put in 3 retirement plans, right? So that becomes the Subhra retirement plan is 3 retirement plans. So that is what it is. Kids understand, 8-year-olds understand that there is something called retirement. You can say, look at Dadaji, look at Nanaji, why are they not working? Because after a particular age, they have to retire. So explain it to them. Explain to them it costs money to get educated, and therefore I'm putting this money. When your kid says, I need a car or a toy or anything, say, yes, see, that is how you invest. So you invest in a piggy bank because you're investing smaller amounts of coins and notes. I'm investing through check, and this is what is happening. Explain the process. It's not some rocket science. Don't think because you're 45 years of age, you know, you can think better than your 5-year-old. You can't. Your brain size has already been fixed long ago. Your brain's processing capacity is also fixed. You just have more information with which to play, and that is actually creating a bias. So your 6-year-old also understands retirement, understands higher education, understands marriage, understands that you want to buy a bigger house. Explain it to them. One day they will turn around and say, why should we have so much money in equity when the equity markets are booming, or something like that, and you are going to be surprised. Your kid did not start talking on day one, right? You spoke, they listened to you, and some of their words are the words which you choose is something which your kids repeat, right? So that is how it is. You didn't sit and teach them talking. You didn't sit and teach them many of those things. Yes, maybe you taught them cycling, but a lot of other things you didn't teach, right? They learnt on their own. So how to sit, how to stand, some of those things you may have taught, but when they go hiking or when they go trekking, they don't take you, right? So they know how to climb a mountain. It's not that you taught them. So similarly, talk about money, talk about investments, talk about involvement, talk about the will, talk about why, what Nanaji has done, what Dadaji has done, what they didn't do, what your Mamaji has done. Do all this, talk to them, get them involved. One day your daughter will surprise you by picking a portfolio better than your son, right? Don't keep denying them that you have no role to play. Tum apna kitchen sambhalo. There are such lousy cooks, women. There are so many women who are such lousy cooks. Believe me, that is equal to the number of men who are such lousy investors. Don't think that your husband is doing a great job. I'm not saying he's doing a bad job, but if you trust him, that's great. But you should also verify what he's doing is right, whether you're going in the right direction. Don't ask him during a bad time, oh, equities are giving 5% return. You would have been better off in PPF. True. So ask him, why is he sticking around when the markets are down? And if he gives you the right reasons, great. Otherwise, you go and read what he's saying. Read a Graham. I'm not saying start with Graham, but read all that. A lot of people will tell you that women may actually make better investors. Jason Zweig says that women may make better investors because they don't compare themselves to other women, right? The men would compare. Men would want, uska return, mera return se jyada kaisa. If you got 36% return, should you be happy or would you be feeling miserable because somebody else got 37? Well, that's how men think, right? So if women don't think like that, of course, women also might be comparing other notes. But then when you start investing, you ask yourself only two, three things, right? Like, goal-based investing. I am goal-based. If I can meet my goal, I'm happy. I don't care a damn what others are getting. Do I need a 36% return? No, I have a very huge saving capacity, so I need only 7% return or 9% return or 10% return. And that I will achieve with a small element of equity and a large amount of debt. That will also work for me. But I understand deferring of taxes, right? Those see what all you must know, learn it, do it, and that makes more sense. And by the way, teach your husband and your son how to cook. Thank you.